I truly think this virtual cell can be like a before and after. Because right now, like, we really sort of like, we have very limited models to understand like how your body works specifically and to be able to sort of do something about it. Actually, let me step back. You have kids, I have kids. So I'm gonna use an analogy that hopefully lots of people here will understand on why this like solving mysteries of the cell is so important. So genome, like most people here, like remember the Human Genome Project, you can get your genome read out. And like that's the blueprint for like how you are unique and you are you. But if we use a Lego example, okay, like people here have built Legos. Mm-hmm. You get in like the new, like not when we were younger where you did generic stuff, you're building cool stuff these days, right?
What do you do with all that stuff once it's built, by the way?
Oh, yeah.
You've got a lot of those.
Okay, but one of the coolest Legos you can build is the Millennium Falcon. So put that in your imagination. Mm-hmm. Like, imagine
I've got that one.
Did you finish it?
Yeah, my son finished it.
Okay,
yeah.
So you've done that.
He's done it.
your body is the Millennium Falcon plus plus. Mm-hmm. And your genome is... or it's just instructions on how to make Legos. It's not even the full, all the Legos you need to make the project. So you go from your genome being like, here's how you make Legos. And then we actually don't know very much about all the way to like, and here's the Millennium Falcon. Like, that gap is that big, okay? And so like, think about like when you get sick, it's the version of being like, these two parts don't come together. Mm-hmm. You've been there, right? Mm-hmm. Why? Mm-hmm. We don't know why. And there's so many steps. We have to go from your genome to RNA, to proteins, to those proteins coming together in complexes, to form a cell, for that cell to come together to form a tissue and an organ. That's a lot of information. And historically, like, we just, like, haven't been able to, like, really look deeply. But in the past 20 years, we've had new technologies come online, and you've all heard about them. CRISPR, mass spec, DNA sequencing, deep imaging. Like, we can do all that. And we've started to generate data sets around this, describing that big gap between Lego and Millennium Falcon. But it's been a bit of like, okay, like, we have all this data, but what does it mean? You're like, we don't want to build the data if we can't pull the insights out of it. And so there's been a little bit of hesitancy, but with the ability to use large language models to make sense of this data and to put it in context and to tell us how this cell actually comes together when we have all this information, that is super powerful. And we can be, like really understand like the mystery of how life comes together from the genome.
So is this going to be like the ChatGPT moment for biology?
I think it's going to be an ability to build a model that allows scientists to ask a lot of scientific questions. Mm. But it's going to be the hypothesis generator. Mm. It's going to allow scientists to say, yeah, that there's something there. I want to understand that. It's a tool to make all the wet lab, because you want to verify all of this. It's a tool to make every scientist, like, supercharge every scientist's brain. And then at CZI, we've had experience, like, I said a lot of data. Like, please don't tell that to anyone who's working on a large language model. Like, I didn't mean it in that way. We have a lot of data for the biology world. Compared to what you need to actually feed to large language models for them to actually, like, be fully utilized, biology is tiny. Mm. So we need to generate more data. Mm. And at CZI, we have experience doing that. For one of the things I'm most proud of is we've been part of building one of the largest single cell data sets describing more than 100 million cells. Again, big for biology, small in AI. But we have the ability to do so much more. And with our research institutes, the biohubs, we have the ability to choose and carefully cultivate the specific data sets we want that can show us the different contours of the cell. And we also, at CZI, we have one of the largest nonprofit life sciences GPU clusters. So we can really support modern computation on these models. Mm. So it's a really exciting nexus of all the different parts of the CZI community that we've been able to do with internally and with partners all over the country.